we must talk.
Not
the matter.
Right. For one or two questions, if you know, we're going to disclose this. The reaction in which the underlying atom is affected. Underlying atom is affected. Is that right? H2SO4. NaCl. Water in degree Kelvin. NH3+, H+. S3P1, BPM, F4, SBF5. Think carefully. Understand the question. A very good question. So, the underlying atom here, sulfur, nitrogen, phosphorus, here are 3, you know. In this particular product side, when a reactant is converted to product, what is the change in the, in which you find change in the hybridization of the underlying atom? Think carefully. Come on, take all of you. In my, are there in the class? In my?
Yes, sir.
Right? 2 minutes time, I'm giving you. When reactant is changing the product, where you find the change in the hybridization? Got it, Chimai? Got it?
No, sir.
Not believe it. Anybody? Come on, Sri Charan.
Sir.
Where do you find the change in the hybridization of the subtle atom?
Sir, C.
D is the answer.
C. Yes, sir.
C. Fourth is the answer.
Third, sir. Third.
D.
What is the answer? Your answer is third. Next, Nitishri, what is your answer? Not getting? Leave it. Ganesh, can you answer?
Sir, fourth or I think fourth.
Fourth one. Your answer is fourth.
Yes, sir.
Look here. Sulfuric acid and NaCl. What is the product you expect here? What is the general product here? Come on, all of you.
NH4 plus.
But the hybridization of many here? What is the hybridization of nitrogen and ammonia? Hybridization and pyramidal, okay. Hybridization.
SP3.
SP3. Come on.
SP3.
This is SP3. This is what is the geometry? What is the hybridization here?
SP3, sir.
SP3, run SP3. Not our answer. SP3, SP3. Next, SCPO2 DPN. What are products?
Sir, PH3 plus what?
Good. PH3. Correct. PH3 and
O2.
O2.
What? DPN and DPN. PH3 and
H2O.
H2O. Talkai. DPN and unmutant say. Something you are saying, you unmutant say. Sanika ready. Unmute, come on.
H2O.
H2O. SP2O and H2O. PH3 and H2O. DPN. Is that ready?
Sir, H2, sir.
Sir, H2.
H2.
Huh? O2, sir.
SCP2. You got it, hypophosphorus acid. Hypophosphorus acid. On strong heating. We are getting DPN now. DPN, you got DPN. SCP2, Baba. SCP1, reduction oxidation. Reduction, oxidation. అది మీకు తెలవాలి తెలపండి ఏం చేయాలి ఆల్రెడీ కంప్లీటెడ్ ఫిఫ్త్ గ్రూప్ ఇది చాలాసార్లు వచ్చింది ఈ క్లాస్ నోట్స్ లో కూడా మెనీ టైమ్స్ తేలింది నోట్స్ ఎస్సీపీఓ2 మనము ఆన్ హీటింగ్ అండర్ గో డిపిఎన్ డిపిఎన్ ఉంది క్లియర్ గా డిపిఎన్ అంటే రిడక్షన్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ ఇక్కడ రిడక్షన్ అండ్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ పిఎస్సీ అండ్ ఎస్సీపీఓ4 రిడక్షన్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ హైడ్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఫాస్ఫరస్ హియర్ ఫాస్ఫరస్ హైడ్రేషన్ What is structure of SCPO2? Hey, Babu! Did you go? SCPO2 is structure, huh? But the adaptation of phosphorus. Phosphorus vibration at the bar, Chapandi.
SP3, sir.
SP3, Ikala. SP3, PSC, pyramid, just like ammonia, it would have pyramid, averaging SP3. But I'm making a phosphorus here. Hey, so the thorough with the hybridization, Mr. Hybridization on the question definitely would like teammates Lagani, I got one on the question definitely would like directly or indirectly in some way to find. Structure and hybridization mein question like a question paper undu you are not thorough with these particular things definitely you are losing 8 marks a chemical bonding la perfect type of adanga I made them to do nearly 200 molecules and molecular ions 200 not some 200 molecules and molecular ions this is sp3 no change this is not the answer What is the product we expect here? You don't have more HBFR? Come on. What is the product?
HBFR.SBFI, sir.
Addition, I agree with you. You don't have 4SBFI. Addition, zero group addition. Addition, simple addition. What is the ion? Ionic form.
XCF3+.
FG6-.
F6-. But average of 0.4 ikkada. 0.4 average enti.
SP3D sir.
SP3D
sir.
SP3D. పేపర్ పైన పెట్టి చూసుకోండి. మీరు ఇంత గాలి చేస్తే కాదని. మీరు ఏదో గాలి చేస్తారు కదా. ఇంత ఏదో ఇట్లా ఇమాజిన్ చేస్తే కాదని. ఇమాజిన్ చేస్తే వచ్చే కాదు అది. ఇమాజిన్ చేస్తే వస్తే అందరి సీట్లు వచ్చాయి. నీకేం సీట్ అందరికి వస్తుంది సీట్. కోచింగ్ తీసుకోవాలి అక్కర్లేదు అసలు.
SP3D2 సార్.
రౌండ్ ద పేపర్ అండ్ చెక్. నీకు వచ్చే మోడల్ ఏందో ట్రై చేయి. ఏ మోడల్?
SP3D2.
SP3D2.
ఒకళ్ళని చెప్తున్నాడు మరి. SP3D2 ఇంతసేపు పడతా. దాన్ని చూడగానే టక్ అని చెప్పేశారు. విత్ ఇన్ 1 సెకండ్ లో చెప్పేశారు దాని హైబ్రిడేషన్. జస్ట్ దాన్ని చూడగానే హైబ్రిడేషన్ అని చెప్పేశారు. రౌండ్ ద పేపర్ అండ్ చెక్. ఇది SP3D2 ఇది. అంటే జామెట్రీ నోట్స్ లో ఉన్నది నేను ఇచ్చాను కూడా. కాబట్టి ఇది కెమికల్ బాండింగ్ లో తరం అయిపోవాలి మనం ఇప్పుడు. పడిదా జామెట్రీ? ఓకే SP3D2 జామెట్రీ. అప్పుడే మీకు కెమిస్ట్రీ ఈజీ అవుతుంది. ఎక్కడైతే మీకు ఫండమెంటల్ కెమిస్ట్రీ పీరియాడిక్ క్లాస్ కెమికల్ బాండింగ్ పోయిందో ఈ దిస్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ యూఆర్ ఫేసింగ్. ఎవ్రీ వేర్ ఏ ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఫర్ యూ. Therefore, you are not getting the perfection because you are missing the periodic classification chemical bonding. Fundamental lessons are atomic structure, kuda. Atomic structure, periodic classification, chemical bonding. Mood most fundamental lesson. Adi neeru 200% perfect kuda. 200% not 100%. Appude meeta chemistry easy aitadi. This is simplest question actually. Easily can identify. SP3, 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 SP3. Then this is what SP3D2. This is SP3D. You can easily identify looking that one. ఎనీథింగ్ యూ పుట్ ఆన్ ద పేపర్ అండ్ చెక్. మీరు గాలి చూసుకుంటే కాదది. దిస్ ఇస్ ఆన్సర్. దిస్ ఇస్ ఆన్సర్. ఈ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఇలా వస్తాయి. నేను ఏదో మామూలుగా చేస్తే కాదు. ఒక్కో క్వశ్చన్ అయితే నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ నేను ఆయన ఇప్పటికే కొంచెం అయిపోయింది. Come on, where you stop it? Our regular class, come on.
Maximum oxidation stage.
Maximum oxidation numbers are completed. Maximum and minimum. To make you to understand is maximum and minimum. Right? I am giving some series of ions. I am putting in front of you some series of ions. Try to answer to my questions. Come on. See the board. Don't write for a while. Now, Cr2O7-2. W2O7-2. Come on, see all of you. What is the name of this one? Name. Ion parent, చెప్పండి. Ion parent.
Dichrome.
Good, dichrome ion. Dichrome ion. What is this one?
Molybdenum.
Yes. Dichromidion, dimolybdenum, dichromidion, dimolybdenum, dimolybdenum, dimolybdenum. Come on, what is the oxygen number of this? Oxygen number?
+7.
Oxygen number of chromium, dichromate?
+6, sir.
+6. ఇది
Plus 6, sir.
Plus 6, sir.
Plus 6.
Plus 6. All are plus 6. Come on, say. All are belonging to which group? Come on. What is the group number of these three? Group number. A group. I don't know. Group number. It's not like notes.
You're 6B. 6B.
6B. 6B. 6B, that is. Right? 6th vertical column. 6B group. Right? Then, in 6B group, what is the maximum oxygen number possible? In 6B group, what is the maximum oxygen number possible? Are a group number to oxygen number in the plus 6 a gala?
Plus 6.
Maximum oxygen number of group number equal to 6, equal to group number. Plus 6. 6th group, maximum oxygen number plus 6. Now, all are having 1A3D, 4D, 5D. All are having plus 6. All are having plus 6. Among these three, which is more stable?
Cr2O, yeah, sir.
Huh? Stable, more stable.
W2O,
sir. Just now they taken a notice for another. Top to the bottom, stability of maximum oxygen number increase. Top to the bottom, stability of maximum oxygen number increase. Then stability kundale. Dichromate ka, di-tungstate ka.
Di-tungstate.
Di-tungstate. Then this is all of stability. This is all of stability. This is less stable. Then this is less stable than this. Order of stability. Got the point? No. So according to our discussion, now dichromate or chromium plus 6 is less stable. Chromium plus 6 is less stable. Now, this is plus 6 is less stable, we are saying. Right? Any oxidation number, for example, any oxidation number which is less stable, any oxidation number which is less stable, either it will try to increase or decrease. What oxidation number is stable in the day, and increase in a chest put on the decrease in a chest put. If oxidation number is less stable, either by increase or by decrease, it gets stabilized. It gets stabilized. Come on. This particular chromium, plus 6 is less stable. Whether it go back to plus 5 state or plus 7 state to become stable?
Plus 5, sir.
Come on.
Plus 5
only. There is no chance for 6. Come on. Therefore, chromium plus 6 always ready to go back to plus 5 and get stabilized. Now, chromium plus 6 is changing into plus 5. Whether it take electron or lose electron? Plus 6 is changing to plus 5. Take electron or lose electron?
Lose electrons.
Taking electrons.
Gain electron or lose electron?
Gain electron.
Now, among these, which is having greater tendency to go back to plus 5? In the 3, which is having greater tendency to go back to plus 5?
Cr2O7.
Chromium plus 6 is less stable. They will try to go back to plus 5. Therefore, that acts on oxidizing it. Whether it is taking electron or losing electron, is it taking electron? So, once it is taking electron, dichromate acts as the oxidizing agent or reducing agent? Taking.
Oxidizing agent.
Losing tendency. Reducing and reducing. A metal is having greater losing tendency. The metal acts as what reducing agent. Okay, that only you remember. Losing tendency, reducing. Gaining tendency?
Oxidize.
More the losing tendency, greater the reducing power. Gaining tendency. And dichromate acts as strong?
Oxidizing.
Order of oxidizing power, I am writing. Order of oxidizing power. Cr2O7.
Would it watch? Is the watch?
O7 minus 2. This is what? Strong oxidizing. That is strong oxidizing power. Order of stability, order of oxidizing power. Right? Series still now applied many times in that section. Not in normal examination, I get advanced only. Next one. Most of you did not follow. I am giving one more series. Same questions I will put to you.
whatever the question they ask you, same questions they are putting to you, try to answer this. Come on, see the board. One more series I'm giving. Seven of four minus. REO four minus. TCO four minus. TCO four minus. REO four minus. Below memories. TCO four minus. And REO four minus. Come on, say all of you. Come on, what is the name of MnO four minus? అరే నేమ్ చెప్పాను బట్ ది నేమ్ ఆఫ్ ఎమ్ఎన్ఓ ఫోర్ మైనస్ నేమ్ ఏమంటావు దాన్ని దాని పేరు ఏంటి పర్మాంగనేట్ కేమైనా అనేది పొటాషియం పర్మాంగనేట్ కే తీసి పక్క పెట్టాను కనుక ఎమ్ఎన్ఓ ఫోర్ మైనస్ పర్మాంగనేట్ అని అంటాం పర్మాంగనేట్ దీని ఏమన్నా మరి ఇది రే ఐ అగ్రీ విత్ యూ యూ వోంట్ గెట్ ఎనీవేర్ ఐఎమ్ గివింగ్ టు యూ కమ్ ఆన్ టీసీఓ ఫోర్ మైనస్ ఇన్ నోనెక్స్ పర్టెక్నేట్ పర్ మాంగనేట్ ఆర్ టెక్నేట్ ఇది Good. Now, is three or belong to which group?
Seventh B.
Seventh B, but the maximum oxygen number possible?
Plus seven.
All are plus seven, no? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Among these, which you feel to be more stable?
REO4.
Good. This is what more stable. Top to the bottom, the stated maximum oxygen number increase. All are having maximum. Therefore, this is what more stable. This is what less stable than this. Less stable than this. Order of stability. Now, our conclusion now. Again, among these, permanganate ion or Mn plus 7 is less stable according to our discussion. The less stable oxidation number, either by increasing or by decreasing, it gets stabilized. Come on, plus 7, we'll try to change to plus 6 or plus 9.
Plus six.
There is no chance for plus six. I agree with you. It is changing to plus six. Among T3, which is having, so come on, plus seven is changing to plus six. Whether take electron or lose electron?
Take electron.
Among B3, which is having greater density, take electron.
MnO4 minus.
Permanganate ion acts as strong.
Oxidizing agent.
Good. Now you follow. Oxidizing agent. MnO4 minus, TCO4 minus, REO4 minus. This is what oxidizing power. This is order of stability, order of oxidizing power, order of stability, order of oxidizing power. I hope you know very well one thing, right? Potassium dichromate, potassium permanganate, commonly used. But oxidizing agents. ఎక్కడ కానీ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్ అంటే మనం K2Cr2SO4 కానీ KMnO4 కానీ యూజ్ చేస్తాం. మిగిలినవి యూజ్ చేయము. ఎందుకు యూజ్ చేయము?
బికాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అ స్ట్రాంగ్ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్.
అంతే, ఏమీ లేదు అక్కడ. ఎక్కడ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్ అయినా మీ ఆర్గానిక్ కెమిస్ట్రీలో కానీ ఎక్కడ కానీ మనం యూజ్ చేసేది పొటాషియం డైక్రోమేట్ కానీ పొటాషియం పర్మాంగనేట్ కానీ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్గా యూజ్ చేస్తాము. మిగిలినవి మనం యూజ్ చేయము. ద రిమైనింగ్ వి నెవర్ యూజ్ because they are not strong oxidizing agents. Therefore, these two are what are strong oxidizing agents. It's clear now. I have put a discussion only in the group I put the discussion. Now I am giving some series of ions in the series. The period is trying. Group la discuss chesamu. I am giving in the series. Few ions I am putting in the series. Look at the board. VO2 plus, CR2O7 minus 2, MnO4 minus. Ego series now. Now, this is CrO4 minus 2, MnO4 minus 2, F2O4 minus 2. Every O4 minus. Do you know what is this UO2 plus? Okay, wait. That is vinodyl ion. What do you call vinodyl ion? What is the oxygen number here?
Plus 9, sir.
Plus?
9, sir.
Okay.
Plus 9, sir.
UO2 plus oxygen number plus?
I.
What is the oxygen number of vanadium here?
Plus 5, sir.
Plus 5. Plus 5. Here, plus 6. Is that on?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Plus 7.
Plus
7.
23, 24, 25. Series. 23, 24, 25. Come on, what
is the
oxygen
number
here?
6.
Plus 6.
Plus 6.
Plus 6.
Plus 6.
Plus 6.
What is the ion name? What is the name of the ion?
Bromate.
Bromate. A2CRO4 potassium bromate, bromate ion. Is it?
Manganate.
Manganate. Is it?
Ferrate.
Good. Let us come to this particular point. Okay. This chromium plus 6, Mn plus 6, and Fe plus 6. No? Good. Among these, which you feel to be strong oxidizing agent? Chromium plus 6, Mn plus 6, Fe plus 6, each are we can cover A, B, C, D, all. Okay. Among the which is strong oxidizing agent? Among the which is strong oxidizing A, B, C, D is all. All are equally oxidizing power. Come on, what is the answer? Which is strong oxidizing among these three?
Chromium.
Chromium.
CrO4 2 minus.
CrO4 is the CrO4 minus 2 is the strong oxidizing agent.
Yes, sir.
Yes, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Not getting it. Okay, one thing. Left to right. Left to right. Atomic and ionic size, decrease or increase?
Decrease.
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 Decrease, sir.
No. This is 24, 25, 26, no. Plus 6, plus 6, plus 6, no. Come on, check. Among B3, which is smaller ion?
Fe, sir.
Fe plus 6. Fe plus 6. A smaller ion is having tendency to lose electron or gain electron?
Gain electron.
Gain
electron. Among these three, which is having tendency to gain electron?
Fe2.
Fe.
Fe.
Fe minus Fe plus 6. Then which is actually the strong oxidizing agent?
Fe4 minus
2. You are saying CrO4 minus 2. You said CrO4 minus 2. According to my discussion, you are saying Fe4 minus 2. This is not oxidizing agent. Order of oxidizing power. This is less than this, this is less than this. I give the explanation. Come to this point again. Come to this point. Here, vanadium plus 5 is strong 6. Right? Among these three, which is strong oxidizing agent?
NO4 minus.
Minus. Because 23, 24, 25, and this is plus 5. This is plus 6. E plus 7. Manganese left to right, ionized decreasing. Still it is having plus 7 oxygen number. Therefore, still smaller. Still smaller. Mn plus 7 is most smallest among D3. Therefore, smaller ion is having tendency to take electron. Taking tendency to oxidizing power. Which is strong oxidizing agent?
NO4 minus.
It's a discussion in the group, it's a discussion in the period.
Period.
Now, one point. Here we have to make a conclusion here. What conclusion? See carefully. Carefully. In a transition series, look, 23, 24, 25. In a transition series, 24, 25, 26. In a transition series, right? The oxygen number is increasing. Oxygen number is increasing. Or oxygen number, same oxygen number. But the oxygen number is increasing. Are having the same oxidation number. Their oxidative power from left to right. Come on.
Increases.
Why
increase?
Size
decrease.
Size
decrease in the ionic side. Decrease in the ionic side. Once again, I am repeating. Okay. In a group, top to the bottom, stability of the oxidation number increase. Maximum oxidation number increase. Therefore, top to the bottom, stability is increased now. Therefore, this is what less oxidizing, this is what more oxidizing. This is what more oxidizing. So top to the bottom, the oxidizing power decrease in the case of group. Now, here in a series, the oxidation number is same, or oxidation number is increasing, from left to right, the oxidative power increase, the oxidative power increase due to decrease in the ionic size, due to decrease in the ionic size. These four series, 1, 2, 3, 4, four series of, remember, these are repeatedly occurring, especially in IIT advanced exam. Be very careful about this. Now take down, come on. This much explanation is required to make you to understand, right? But see, order of oxidative power. Order of stability. Order of stability. First one, order of stability. This is order of oxidizing power. Order of oxidizing power. Order of stability. Order of oxidizing power. Order of oxidizing power. Okay, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, for the last two, for the last two. Right, generalization, not. For the last two, these two, not. In a transition series, for these two only. The statement is applicable to these two only. In a transition series, the oxygen number is seen, or increase in oxygen number, seen or increase in oxygen number. Their oxidizing power, increase from left to right. Left to right. This is due to decrease in the ionic size. Decrease in the ionic size. Ionic size. Right, next. Okay. Our oxidized number is generally a question is repeated every in the exam. Now let's see. Suppose you consider M and O. We are given the compounds of same element with different oxidized numbers. M and O, MnO2, MnO2, suppose MnO3. So what is the oxygen number here? Plus 2. What is the oxygen number here? Plus 4. What is the oxygen number here? Plus 6. Oxygen number here? Plus 6. So minimum oxygen number, where do they want to be basic or ionic minimum? Basic or ionic, see the word. Highest, acidic. Acidic, acidic, ionic, therefore covalent. Acidic, covalent. The medium oxygen number, this is found to be amphoteric. This is found to be amphoteric. This is minimum. Medium oxygen number, among these, medium oxygen number, among these, maximum oxidation number. Accordingly, you can decide you got basic ionic, acidic, covalent. This is what amphoteric. So, based on this particular concept, different questions are appearing in the examination. I frame two questions on this particular concept. Take as it is, come on. As it is, take it.
MnO?
Come on, Malika, ready? Can you answer this? MnO is least acidic. Malika, ready? Right?
Yes, yes, sir.
Dead time, come on. Least acidic. Least acidic means more basic.
No, sir. No, sir, I didn't get it.
Come on, all of you, what is the answer here?
VCl2.
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 Plus 2, plus
3,
plus 4.
Plus
4,
plus
5. These are more basic. In that way, you have to understand. This one. One more question, come on. Among the following, which is Highly basic. Come on, all of you.
You wrote CrO2 two times, sir.
Right, right, ma. Okay, CrO3, CrO2, CrO, CrO2, both three are right. CrO2. Okay. Car. This is highly basic. Come on.
CrO, sir.
CrO3.
CrO.
CrO.
Right. These are the questions. Questions appear like a very simplest concept. nothing to be confused here. Come on, next variation. Copper hornets. I have this one. CO, F2 is there. CO, CL2 is there. CO, BR2 is there. But remember, CO, I2 is not there. Really, we never see any CO, I2. CO, I, we see. CO to I2, we see. But CO, I2 is not there. CO, CL2, CO, BR2, CO, F2 is there. So CO, I2 is not there. Can you say why? Can you say why? Copper plus 2, remember. Copper plus 2 is strong oxidizing agent, remember. Copper plus 2 is strong oxidizing agent. Therefore, oxidizes I minus. Oxidizes I minus to I2. I minus I2, and it gets reduced to Cu to I2. Therefore, copper sulfate with a what? 2CuSO4, 4Ki, 4Ki. Copper plus 2 is strong oxidizing agent. Oxidizing K to I2. Then a very word, Cu to I2 plus I2, then a very 2K2SO4. Or ionic equation, also we can write an example to give ionic equation. Cu plus 2 plus 4I minus. What are say? Don't confuse. Then it is what? Cu to I2 plus what? I2. So, copper plus 2 got oxidizing agent, oxidizes. Oxidizes I minus 2, I2, therefore Cu, I2 is not existing, it easily converts into what? Cu to I2, 2 plus iodine. This is existing, but not this, but not this. One more point. Now, copper plus 1 is not stable in aqueous solution. In aqueous solution, copper plus 1 is not existing. Simply it is changing into what? Copper plus 2. Because copper plus 1 in aqueous solution is not stable, because if copper plus 1 in aqueous solution easily undergo TPN, disproportionation. Okay, 2Cu plus 1 easily undergo disproportionation, produce copper plus 2 and copper 0 and plus 2. Here we are oxidation, here we are reduction. Therefore, copper plus 1 is not stable in aqueous solution. Why not stable? Copper plus 2, heat of reduction is more than copper plus 1. Therefore, the heat of fertilization of this particular copper plus 2 can easily remove 2 electrons from copper. Therefore, copper plus 1 you are putting into water, simply changing into what? Copper plus 2. Because copper plus 1 easily undergo TPN in aqueous solution. Because copper plus 2 is more stable than copper plus 1 in aqueous solution. This is due to greater heat of fertilization of copper plus 2. Right on. CuF2, CuCl2, CuBr2 are there. CuCl2, CuBr2 are there. But CuI2 is not there. CuI2 is not there. Not there. Because copper plus 2 is oxidizing agent. Oxidizes I minus to I2 at least two, right? These two equations. Go back to third one, only two. Both are same. Copper plus 1 in aqueous solution is not stable. Copper plus 1 in aqueous stress solution is not stable because it undergoes DPN in aqueous solution. It undergoes DPN in aqueous solution. This one. Let us say copper plus 2 in aqueous solution is stable, madam, because greater heat of adhesion. Copper plus 2 is stable in aqueous solution because greater heat of hydration of copper plus 2. Copper plus 2. Right. This completes oxidation numbers, different concepts in this. Then magnetic properties. Magnetic properties. See, most of the d-block element in the compounds, most of the d-block element in their compound, except a few. Most of the d-block element in the compounds generally are paramagnetic because of presence of unpaired electrons in d orbitals. Because the presence of unpaired electrons in d orbital d1, d2, d3 like this, the presence of unpaired electrons in d orbital, most of the d block elements in their compounds are exhibiting what are paramagnetic. Next. Different magnetic properties you come across. You know that paramagnetic substance, paramagnetic substance. Next one, diamagnetic substance. Next, ferromagnetic substance, and anti-ferromagnetic substance. Again, ferromagnetic substance. Like this, many magnetic substances are there. Paramagnetic, diamagnetic, ferromagnetic, antiferromagnetic, ferrimagnetic substance. Like this, different magnetic substances are there. Let us see, we have discussed about these magnetic substances. You know the paramagnetic. The substance is generally attracted by the magnet. What do you call the paramagnetic substance? The paramagnetic substance generally carry unpaired electrons. The paramagnetic substance generally carry unpaired electrons. Next. Diamagnetic. The substance which is actually repelled by the magnet. The substance generally repelled by the magnet. What is called repelled by the magnet? What is called diamagnetic substance? This particular diamagnetic substance is carrying this water. Paid arithmetic electrons. Paid arithmetic electrons. Right, I agree. All this you also know. Now, I am putting a question to you. Why the paramagnetic substance is attracted to the magnet? Come on, say. Why the paramagnetic substance is attracted by the magnet?
Because they are unpaired.
But why is paramagnetic substance attracted to the magnet?
Sir, they are unpaired, not sir.
Unpaired electron. I only said to you, unpaired electrons are there attracted. That's what the question is. If unpaired electrons are there, why it is attracted? What happens? That's the question. Yes, unpaired electrons are there, I agree with you. If unpaired electrons are there, what happens? Why it is attracted? Good, come on. Why? Yes, unpaired electrons are attracted. Why attracted? What happens? Come on.
Sir, opposite spin electrons attract each other.
Where is opposite spin electrons?
Sir, if opposite comes in contact, then attraction is there.
Where is opposite, you are saying? See, correct only. Come on. Correct only.
If the electrons act like a magnet, sir.
Yes. The unpaired electron may be plus of spin or minus of spin in the substance. And a magnet will be magnet. North pole and south pole. One pole is plus of, the other pole is got minus of. Any unpaired electron, plus of or minus of, always tries to make its spin zero. Therefore, plus of spin or minus of spin attracted towards either of minus of spin or plus of spin. Therefore, a substance with unpaired electron, paramagnetic, attracted towards either north pole or the south pole. Therefore, the paramagnetic substance is attracted by the magnet. Yes. Next, why a diamagnetic substance is repelled by the magnet? That's the question. Come on. Why a diamagnetic substance is repelled by the magnet?
Sir, one electron among both the electrons which paired, one will rotate in clockwise, other will anti-clockwise. One will attract one side, other will repel that side, sir.
Where repulsion? They are not free, no. They are not independent. They are actually paired. You cannot say one is okay. One is clockwise, otherwise one is other anti-clockwise. But they are actually paired. There is no spin. Spin is overall zero. But a paired electron, there is no plus of spin, minus of spin. Spin is overall zero. Why still it is repelled? That's the question. Why it is repelled? Spin is zero, no? Why it is repelled? Okay, paramagnetic plus of or minus of may be attracted to the minus of spin or plus of spin. Spin is zero here. Still it is repelled. Why? It should not show any response, no? But follow my question. Spin zero, I have a response to do. We have a ripple line from it. Why? Huh? Having an idea? This you get in even physics also. Magnetic momentum, this, that, you are getting in even physics also. Huh? Whenever a diamagnetic substance is kept in magnetic field, Remember, small, induced, temporary. Three words are using. Small, temporary, induced. Paramagnetic moments are generated. In the substance. Small, induced, temporary. Paramagnetic moments are generated. These paramagnetic moments are working in opposite direction to the field of the magnet. Therefore, the substance is actually repelled by the magnet. It is not due to spin and all, nothing. It is only due to the diamagnetic behavior is due to small, induced, temporary paramagnetic moments generated by the magnetic field. Those paramagnetic moments work in opposite direction to the field of the magnet. Therefore, that particular substance is repelled by the magnet. I am using about small, I said temporary. As long as the magnetic field is there, they work. If you remove the magnetic field, they are not working. Therefore, diamagnetic moment or diamagnetic property induced one, influential one. Therefore, diamagnetic effect is less than paramagnetic effect. Next, ferro. Do you know what is ferro? Any substance which exhibits greater paramagnetic moment than expected from the number of unpaired electrons. For example, in this three unpaired electrons. Once three unpaired electrons are there, theoretically you can say its magnetic moment should be 3.8. Magnetic moment we are expecting theoretically 3.8. 4 magnetic. We are expecting 3.8. But surprisingly, it is expecting 4.8. We are expecting 3.8. But exhibiting more than the expected theoretically. That particular substance, what you call ferromagnetic substance. The substance which exhibit greater paramagnetic moment than expected from the number of unpaired electrons. We are expecting 3.8, but that is exhibiting 4.8. such a substance what we call ferromagnetic substance. Ferromagnetic substance. Why the substance behaves like ferro? Why, whether all the substances are behaving like ferro or some of the substances behave like ferro, why a ferro property arises? Ferro property arises. It's a paramagnetic. But whenever paramagnetic centers are very near to each other, suppose you take a substance. You are taking a substance. I said, this is what ferro. Why ferro? The paramagnetic centers are very near to each other. Like this. When the paramagnetic centers are very near to each other, alignment is possible. The magnetic moment of this aligning with this one, 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 all together working in the same direction. Therefore, a substance is surprisingly exhibiting greater than expected, because aligning is possible, because they are very near to each other. Therefore, the substance is exhibiting greater paramagnetic moment than expected. In a ferro substance, magnetic centers are very near to each other, alignment is possible. Alignment is possible. What are the examples? Now, just examples are manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, in some of the compounds, not all compounds. Especially the ferromagnetic substances are manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, some of the compounds. And in your NCERT book, clearly given CRO group. CRO. This question appeared the recent exams twice in the recent last exams. CRO is the best ferromagnetic substance. The CRO is generally given in magnetic tapes, cassette recorders. Magnetic tapes and cassette recorders. The substance usually is CRO2, because CRO is what? Ferromagnetic substance. Ferro. Another substance, European monoxide. European monoxide also, best ferro substance. European monoxide, that is lanthanide. Next one more, it is Mn2CuSn. Mn2CuSn alloy. This is a particular alloy. This also acts as a good ferromagnetic substance. Next, in a ferromagnetic substance, the alignment of magnetic moment vectors, the representation of alignment of magnetic moment vectors in a ferro substance is all are working in the same direction. I said no. Therefore, representation is like this. All are working in the same direction. The representation of magnetic moment vectors in a ferro substance is represented like this. Often they are giving the diagram, only arrow type of diagram they are giving. Among these, which is represent ferro substance, which is represent antiferro substance, which is represent ferrous substance. This is the representation of magnetic moment vectors in a particular ferro substance. Coming to antiferro. Look here. Antiferro. Come on, what antiferro? Opposite meaning to ferro. Come on. The substance exhibit lesser paramagnetic moment than expected from the number of unpaired. For example, suppose this particular compound we are having four unpaired electrons. For example, four means it has to exhibit 4.8 of magnetic moment. Theoretically, you or me, we can expect 4.8 magnetic moment we have to expect. But surprisingly, it is only 3.1. We are expecting 4.8. 4 magneton. But it is exhibiting only 3.1. We are expecting 4.8, exhibiting 3.1. Such substance what we call antiferro. Antiferro. The substance will exhibit lesser paramagnetic moment than expected in the number of 100 atoms. Such substance what we call antiferro substance. Why a substance behaves like antiferro? Antiferro. Come on. Why a substance behaves like antiferro? Now, in any substance, the paramagnetic centers are away from each other. You can understand? The better way are, they are very near. Alignment is possible. Easily aligning because near. Here, away from each other. This cannot align with this one. They are working in different directions. Therefore, often they may all work opposite to each other. Overall, an antiferrous substance often can exhibit zero magnetic moment. Often that may happen because all are working in opposite direction, so that magnetic moment may go down to zero also. Therefore, it is exhibiting lesser than expected. What are the examples? Some of the MO type and M2O3 type. some of the MO type and M2O3 type of oxides of tungsten metals. MO and M2O3 type of oxides of tungsten metals exhibiting antiferro property. Antiferro property. Best other example antiferro is cupric acetate is also best antiferro substance. In a the representation of magnetic moment vectors in antiferro substance. So ferro substance all are working in the same direction. In antiferro substance, all are not working in the same direction. Represent the magnetic moment vectors in the direction aligning in the field opposite. In the field, opposite. In the field, opposite. In the field, opposite. Like this, they are working in the direction of the field of the magnet, opposite to the direction of the field of the magnet. This is a representation of magnetic moment vectors in an antiferrous substance. Then we have to switch over to ferri magnetic substance. There is no place on the board. Right? This one is not so that we will continue on the remaining part. Come on. Most of the D-block elements and their compounds. D-block elements and their compounds exhibit paramagnetic property. Paramagnetic property due to presence of unpaired electrons in d orbitals. Unpaired electrons in d orbitals. Right. Magnetic substances. First one, paramagnetic substance. Attracted by the magnet, carry unpaired electrons. Next, diamagnetic substance. Repelled by the magnet. Carry paired arrangement of electrons. Next to that, the diamagnetic behavior is due to small induced temporary paramagnetic moments. Which work in opposite direction to the field of the magnet. Therefore, that substance is repelled by the magnet. The substance is repelled by the magnet. Next. And the diamagnetic behavior is, inducer one, therefore, its effect is less than paramagnetic effect. Paramagnetic effect. Example, the zinc oxide, the chromium oxide, Pi board. But one note, right? One note. Pi board exhibits the paramagnetic moment. It should be +4 there. But it is non-stoichiometric. It carries little amount of Pi bond. Therefore, exhibits little paramagnetic moment. Right or not? Pi bond exhibit little paramagnetic property because it is non-stoichiometric. That it carry PiO2 plus PiO. Come on next. Ferro. The substance which exhibit greater paramagnetic moment than expected from the number of unpaired electrons. Number of unpaired electrons. Known as ferromagnetic substance. Next. In a ferromagnetic substance, the paramagnetic surface of near to each other, and the magnetic fields align, the direction of the field of the magnet. Examples. Manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, and some of the compounds. Next one, CrO2. Next one,
you hope? Next one. Memento, C2, SN, alloy. Memento, C2, SN, alloy. C2, SN, alloy. C2, SN, alloy. Right or not? CrO2, be the question two times the recent exams because you will take in an extra book as a thing. CrO2 is used in magnetic tapes, and in cassette recorders. Magnetic tapes and in cassette recorders. Next point. The representation of magnetic moment vectors in a ferrous substance. Show this one. Put all the arrows one direction. One direction. Next, antiferrous substance. Antiferrous substance. The substance which exhibit lesser paramagnetic moment than expected from the number of 100 electrons. Known as antiferrous substance. In antiferrous substance, the paramagnetic centers are away from each other. Cannot align in the direction of the field of the magnet. Often the antiferrous substance may exhibit zero magnetic moment. Zero magnetic moment. Wow. Last one. Hello. 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 Sir. Sir.
Examples. M O and M two. What the type of? M O and M two. What the type of? Oxides of transition metals. Oxides of transition metals.
Sir, those last two are not visible, sir. After FeO, they are not visible. After FeO, after FeO, two last two compounds are not visible.
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay now.
Yes sir.
Visible?
Yes sir. Yes sir. Now visible.
Tell me what they. Alignment of magnetic moment vectors. Alignment of magnetic moment vectors in antiferrous substance. This one. In antiferrous substance. In antiferrous substance. This one. They are giving up in this particular diagrams. Which of the following represents ferro, antiferro, ferri? One more substance in the ferri substance. Tomorrow I'll continue. The way, tomorrow I'll continue. Doubts are there, tomorrow I'll clear it.
Okay.
No time now. I have to go somewhere.
Okay.
No time, well, tomorrow.